All right, welcome back to Poppy Playtime Chapter 3. Let's get this area over with. I do not like those creepy crawling critters one bit. I can use it as like a barrier. But there's just too many. I gotta go. It's either cat. Oh, what is this area? They're everywhere. We're just gonna have to power through them. I'm assuming we gotta go to the other side and do the same thing to the other block. Gotta make sure the ammo count is being conserved. Where else do I go? Just imagine being pulled apart by dozens of these little critters eating you. Ugh. Are they in here? No, I think I'm good. Check upstairs real quick. There's no room for you here. Oh, trust me, I understand. Not planning on staying here one bit. It's a dead end. Cadnap went on some sort of killing spree. You just see claw marks all over Playcare. Just how many people has he been killing? Oh, this is like Catnap's bed. I'm still waiting. Well, I'm right here, Catnap. You could have gotten me at any moment. Are you afraid of my little flare gun?
You.
Dog Day.
You're Pappy's angel. Come to save us. Nothing left to save. Not here. Bird Catnap's home, Angel. Their home. A myriad pairs of eyes are on you now. Watching, waiting, hungry. They want nothing more than to crawl beneath your skin and eat away at you bit by little. This is what he does to heretics. These little toys follow Catnap to avoid that very fate. And in return, they are fed. We try to fight it. The prototype's control. I am the last of the smiling critters. Listen to me. You need to get out of this place. You need to live. You and Poppy could fix this. End this madness. The torment. Oh no. Oh no. Leave me. Please. Just go. Run.
Oh man. Where am I going to run to? Oh. Run! Oh, he's pretty fast. It crawled inside him and ate him. And then they puppeted him. I can't believe I missed that. All right, first try. Oh, hey, Dog Day.
Dog Day says, fetch! Go, go, as far as you can! Why are you just standing there? You can't be here. You can't stay.
Damn. Poor Dog Day. Was that the sound of when his feet were getting gnawed off? That playground is absolutely nuts now. Especially with Dog Day crawling around as a giant meat puppet, it's an absolute no-go zone.
Hey, are you all right? No ouchies or lost body parts? I'm really glad you're okay. I don't want to lose any more friends to this place. Hey, did you see the shrine? Catnap made it for the prototype. See, before Catnap turned into Catnap, I guess there was some pretty serious accident. He almost died, but they say that the prototype saved his life, giving up his own freedom in the process. In Catnap's eyes, the prototype is a superhero and has saved this place. So Catnap treats him like a god, killing everyone that opposes him, us included, if we're not careful. That shrine, did it scare you? If you thought that was terrifying, just wait until you see the real thing. Anyways, we're really close to the end. I sent you a new key. You're going to the counselor's office instead. It's not ideal, but it should have enough juice. If you can get that generator going and plug it in, I think we'll be done. And keep your eyes open for Catnap. Every shadow.
Well, that definitely explains what we saw earlier with Catnap standing before that shrine. So my question is, did the prototype save Catnap before he was turned into that machine?
The following message is for all Playtime Company employees. At 11.01 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, an unknown hostile force was declared present within the Playtime Company facility. Personnel are to begin enacting emergency evacuation protocols immediately. Leave all personal belongings. Do not engage with any hostile individuals. If no exit path is available, seek shelter in a hidden location. Use blankets or pillows to cover your body, and remain silent. Do not look through any windows. Do not open doors for any individuals. Do not make eye contact.
Open the doors now. The hour of joy has arrived. Okay, so the hour of joy was when everything went down and all the employees started getting massacred. So those little toys that we saw in blood piles here, being impaled, hung on the ceiling, there's somehow people transformed into little toys, and they're being hunted by catnap. It's really morbid now when you look back on all the dead toy bodies that we've come across. Head of school, Maria Ashokan. It has like the little handprints where I can move the desk, but I can't do that. Joy, oh man. They were getting murdered left, right, and center. Turn and go home. I'm in too deep now. Is there nothing here to scope out or check out? Is there nothing here to read? I was hoping we'd get something from this head office. Ah, what do we have here? Head of toy store, Eduardo Gaffa. They have a bunch of toys, but they're not in the boxes. Hey man, free money. Guess we're well past caring about that right now. Ooh, man, the hour of joy, though. Creepy stuff to think about. I'm guessing I'm supposed to go back up there and relight that. Oh, wait, we can't do that now because of the platform. So how about we do it this way? All right, what do we have here? Head of Playcare, Stella Graber. Most important thing, where's the tape? There we go. Hartman incident. Yeah. Okay. What do we got here?
Oh, Mr. and Mrs. Hartman. Come on in. Please, have a seat. How was your ride down?
It was, nothing like we were expecting. Mr. Ludwig's speech was... Well, it just confirms for us that you're the orphanage we want to go through.
It's a truly magical place. I felt right at home from the second I entered. You opened that door the first time and you just know. You're never going to leave. Kind of like finding a home as a child and always thinking of it when you want to feel comforted. I understand you want to give Jeremy that home?
Yes, and we would like to adopt.
Ah, amazing! You'll be perfect for... Oh.
What?
Well, it appears there's been some complications.
Complications? What kind of complications?
I don't know. The form says testing.
What does that mean? Tell us, what does that mean?
Miss Graber, we deserve a better explanation than that, don't you think?
You're in charge of all this! How could you not know?
And why are we only finding out about this now?
I don't. I'm sorry.
She was the head of the entire Playcare, and even she did not know what was going down below with the experiments. Okay, so she just probably went crazy. Your time is running short. Turn and go home. I can't exactly do that. Poppy wouldn't let me. I did try to do that before, though. head of Home Sweet Home, Lisa Botian. They got Lisa. Well, they got more than Lisa. What I'm assuming, they got every single employee in Playtime Company except for me. At a production. Nate Carpenter. I hope there's no secrets I've missed because some of these have been openable. Head of Playhouse, Greg Fecto. Greg, I have a couple complaints about Playhouse. It's pretty filthy. You should get that cleaned up. And don't forget to address the army of tiny swarming demons prowling around there. Okay, we got some power. Sweet. Got a little jumping puzzle. It's going to require some finessing. There's a battery in a case. Am I supposed to drop it? Uh-oh. What's going on with this game? Alright, I see what we gotta do. Oh, nice. It teleports up here. It's like a little failsafe. And break. Do I need to have this up here? Then drop it from this height? There we go. Ah, okay. Should be able to do that from here, right? Who's playing the smooth jazz? Who's playing smooth jazz? Is that Catnap? He's very talented. Oh, damage builds up quick in the gas. Run? Oh, I sure will. Run until like... Oh, hello.
To end this. Do you even know what's real?
Oh, this is during the hour of joy. How many people were employed at Playtime Company? Yeah, Catnap, this whole entire time you've just been stalking me and just threatening me. You just, come on. When are you going to come in for the kill, man? Are you just intimidated by my two big, gigantic, muscular hands? Look, man, I'm trying to leave Playcare. Trust me, I am. Right as soon as I move that red mist of yours. Although I do find it interesting that beings like Catnap and Mrs. Delight aren't immediately a threat until I keep poking around. So maybe they're a little bit different than Huggy Wuggy and Mommy Longlegs, or maybe they're just toying with me. But either way, more questions, and hopefully we'll get more answers on the next episode, because that's all the time I have for today, everybody. This has been Pazekal. Take care.